Okay, my name is Bin Mahdi Milad. I'm a student at the University of Oklahoma. I'm doing my PhD in geology department, working with my advisor, Dr. Roger Slatt. And the topic of my poster today is who should make the optimum upscaling decisions, a geologist or an engineer, or maybe both of them. So the long story short is what's the effect of upscaling on the static and dynamic modeling? Let's begin with the definition of upscaling. Here you have a conceptual model of static model with numerous numbers of cells, and then you sampled your static model, and then you average all the properties in, and you reduce the small size of those static model to become a coarse model with less numbers of cells. So in this case, you reduce the number of cells, and also you change the actual reservoir heterogeneity in this case. Once you run your coarse model to be dynamic, you will see different response of your dynamic simulation. Here are some of the examples on how the upscaling, different upscaling levels will affect the performance of your reservoir, whether it's a water production or oil and gas production. However, we are focusing on oil and gas production. If you can see, here is the purple line, which is this one, the prediction of your water performance with model size from 50 by 50 meter. And once you coarse your model and you reduce the number of cells from 50 to 200 by 200, you have a different trend of the production. And if you compare this fine scale model with the larger scale model, you will see 50% of decreasing after you upscale. This is will not give you an accurate accurate prediction of your reservoir performance. So which one do you believe, the fine scale model or the coarse scale model? So this is one of the questions that I'm working on it, and also how would you be able to eliminate the small thin beds where you have different petrophysical properties for those thin beds, and then you upscale them and you estimate their properties with other adjacent beds, you will have different performance here as well. Not only that, sometimes when you change the level of upscaling vertically from 9 to 38, you will have different facies representation, and also when you make statistical analysis by having different realization models, you will see here you have different response of your production. So these are the questions that I'm working on them. So I'm proposing the methodology for this issue, preliminary methodology to solve this issue. First of all, I believe that in order to have actual representation of your reservoir model, which is that's what we are here today, what's the reality of reservoir, we need to stop making assumptions and have actual representation. I believe that multiple disciplines must be combined and work must be combined together in order to have the actual reservoir representation to be modeled. So you begin with the geology, petrophysics, geophysics, which is the seismic, and you have the fracture, actual fracture model. There is no assumption here, and you can create this actual fracture model from the seismic, which is geophysics, and the petrophysics, as well as the geophysics, and then you integrate the production data in order to have the actual reservoir model in order to develop and conduct upscaling. Here is, you have
As I mentioned here, it's similar to, this is the input data for the static fine scale model, and then you conduct different multiple realization, and you select the three models only because it's not economic to have all of them. So, and then you run simulation, which is engineer do, which is I'm going to do that. And then you carry those three models, P10, P50, P90, and you run different upscaling and compare those results with the fine scale model in order to have the